Alright, I'm back with a new Genshin Impact video. Not about a build or anything this time, or a character pull or anything, but just the kind of my overall impressions and an early review of the update 1.3 Lantern Rite event. This is probably one of the most elaborate events they've done so far, and that's kind of saying something. It's got story components, and then it's got an entirely new mini game they cooked up called Theater Mechanicus, I think that's what it's called. That is essentially, they put a tower defense game inside Genshin Impact, which sounds really random and like it might not work, but it works. It works really well. The event itself, I think, is very cool. And, you know, this is a Chinese game, and this is obviously sort of loosely tied to the Chinese New Year, or the Lunar New Year. And they've really gone all out for the decorations of Liyue. It looks really good. They have lanterns everywhere. They really kind of change things up. There's like a whole kind of market near the docks that is very good looking, and they've really kind of put a lot of work in here. And it comes with a main story component, which is Xiao has arrived, and I've already talked about him a lot. I pulled him, I did a build video, and then after I did that build video, I like doubled his damage, and I wish I could have just deleted it and re-uploaded it. But the whole thing is focused on him. You make Xiao lanterns, they're called, and Eevee's decided it's time to roll around, so there you go. And you make Xiao lanterns, and you kind of, you know, you're supposed to set them loose, but in this event, Xiao lanterns are a currency for playing Theater Mechanicus. There are like login rewards, there are daily quests that pop up, and there are, I think, three different stages of this, where there's gonna be other kind of mini events going up. Eventually you're gonna be able to get a free 4-star character of your choice from a kind of limited pool there. And yeah, so far, the main draw is Theater Mechanicus, and I'll roll one of my runs here, which sadly is not a flawless run because I screwed up a little bit, but the entire point of this minigame is tower defense with the elemental system that is already kind of baked into the game. And you set up elemental towers, you can upgrade them between rounds, but then you can also upgrade them outside of the game to increase your damage. I did not realize this at first, so I kept wondering when I was failing, but if you kind of keep up with your upgrades, it gets a lot easier. So you're trying to use the elemental combos against enemies that often very slowly march down the different paths to try and get to your end goal. I mean, everyone's been playing tower defense games for ages. I started playing tower defense games when I was, it was like back in StarCraft 1 with custom maps. And then, you know, I've evolved, you know, over time I'm playing like Bloons tower defense and stuff like that. And I've played all manner of these. This is not maybe the most elaborate one I've ever seen because it's just a mini game within a main game, but I'm impressed with how kind of expansive it is and the work they've put in and how fun it is. And it's cool to make these kind of elemental combinations and calculations about what will clear the waves the fastest. One additional factor to consider here is that you can also use your characters to, you can't do any damage, but you can use your character's elemental effects to prime enemies, I guess, for running into your towers. So for example, in this run, I was doing this with Venti a lot, where you can pop people up and do swirl, but lately I've just been doing Child, because once you have him, and when you do his E, every attack applies Hydro to enemies, so you can just kind of always make sure everyone is soaked so you can electrocute them and freeze them and stuff. Later on you'll see when things like Abyss Mages come, you can get through their elemental shields with something like, you know, Hydro, things like that. The way I screwed up here is I didn't have anyone fire on my team. I should have brought someone, and I didn't get through, I think, some ice armor in time, and I let somebody through later on here. But it's really fun. There's been like a new difficulty and new stages that unlock almost every day. I don't think there was a new one that unlocked today for some reason, but they're slowly getting harder and harder. Like, it was really easy at first, but now we're up to ones that are like three different paths kind of converging, which is why in this video I built my tower so far back, because the first time I did this I didn't even realize there was a third path, and I placed all my towers wrong. But it can take a few tries to like learn the map, but once you do, it's pretty straightforward and pretty easy. Doing entirely perfect runs can be a little difficult, because even if one gets through, you might not get whatever the achievement is. The ultimate goal of this is to build up enough, like do enough achievements and build up enough currency where you can shop at the Xiao Market And that is just, there's a ton of stuff there. It's your usual kind of collection of stuff for events like this, where it's XP and ore and ascension materials, and then the limited edition crown upgrade material that you can only get from events. And just, there's a whole lot of stuff that is going to be valuable. And of course, this is all free, which is great. Events, they've said all their major events are no longer going to use resin. It's been like that for a little while because people need resin to do normal things in the game. And in this event particularly, like, it's not even combat focused, so it really does not matter, like, if you don't have a, you know, full 5-star roster. Like, yeah, I'm using my 5-stars, but you can, you know, there's plenty of heroes you can use to just cover people and elements, and your damage doesn't matter or anything like that. So this is a very accessible event, and it's something that is different than the usual combat focus of the game, and I'm really enjoying it. I'm curious to see how the last half of the difficulty pans out here. Past this, there has been some story components. There was the Zhao mission opened it, and that had us kind of playing alongside Zhao to prove that this guy was, like, using fake magic powers, that he was supposed to be one of the, what are they, the Yaksha? Is that what it's called? He's, like, mystical elemental beings that Zhao was, like, the last, he's, like, one of the last two surviving ones. It was an interesting quest because it really ended, like, this guy's like a scam artist, and he's like charging people money to do fake miracles, and then Zhao has to step in when there's like an actual threat. But it ends with like the guy being like super apologetic and like really honored to meet Zhao and like pledging to turn his life around, and like, it's actually a very wholesome quest, which I was not kind of expecting, because we've all, you know, we've all done like the scam artist quests in video games before, but usually you don't end like that. So I thought that was interesting and continues Genshin's surprisingly good storytelling. And then before this, there was the quest with Dansleaf, is that his name? Where he's essentially your brother's Paimon. Like, he's his traveling companion. So that kind of moved the story forward a little bit, because we're still looking for, well, your brother or sister, depending on who you chose. So that was interesting, and that, I'm curious to see where that goes. That was like right when all this, when update 1.3 launched, and it wasn't technically part of Lantern Rite, but it still kind of fed into this. And then every day you're getting kind of new Lantern Rite based quests where you are trying to help various people celebrate the Lantern Rite in some way. These are usually pretty basic quests. They don't really have voice work. It's just like you have to go and help somebody, you know, write a poem for their girlfriend or something like that. Or like, one I did today was this little girl was trying to give a lantern to a little boy so he could make a wish that his father would like stop being sick, which is, you know, adorable. But the whole quest is like literally, you know, talk to her about making lanterns, go put a lantern on a roof, and like, that's the whole quest. You make lanterns by farming materials that come from literally anywhere. The drop, like, any ore drops one of the materials, any plant drops one of the materials, and then any hill troll kill drops one of the materials. So if you're doing anything, you will never be short of Zhao lanterns. And it costs one Zhao lantern to play each round of Theater Mechanicus. And then some of these quests require anywhere from 1 to 3 Zhao lanterns, but I already have more than I can ever possibly spend. And if you play too much Theater Mechanicus, like, you hit, after this video, I hit the resource cap. So now when the new upgrades kick in tomorrow, I'll be ready to buy them. But there's only so much you can really play to make it worthwhile. And I think I've done all the challenges I can before more stuff is unlocked. There are two more phases to this. I don't know exactly how it's going to change. There were events listed that MiHoYo has gone through. And one of them is the choosing the free character thing. And then there might be one about the Geovishap boss. I can't remember if that's just the one that's going on right now or if there's something special there. But I think that we'll get more story components, and there'll probably be a story component to close this. And then we wait, 4 weeks for... by the time this is over, this is like a, I think it's a 3-week event, pretty sure. We'll be getting close to update 1.4 and possibly the release of Hu Tao and whatever is going on next. I think update 1.5 might be the big one where we get a whole new zone, but I need to double check that. For now, this is just sort of another fun interim. I really enjoyed, I don't know if I like this as much as Dragonspine. I don't know if Dragonspine was technically an event. Like, it was kind of an event. There were some event components to it, but it was also like a permanent addition to the game, whereas I don't think, you know, anything here is really a permanent addition to the game. it's just this temporary celebration, and it'll go back to normal after this. But it's been very well done, as all their live events are very well done, and they just pop up so frequently, as do all these updates. Their pace of content is pretty astonishing. In terms of my current projects, I just leveled Noelle up to 80 and put a good amount of work into her for an artifact kit, because I did not have any Geo characters, really. And then I am finally going to start leveling my Diluc that I got when I pulled two Zhaos, and I'm realizing that I really need a fire character, because my other ones just weren't cutting it. Xiangling and Xinyan, they're okay, but now that I have Diluc, I mean, you know, what other fire character do you really need? So I'm going to start investing more in him, and he's like level 50 or 60 or something now, so he's getting there, but he'll be one I'll probably, you know, obviously want to take all the way to 90. I am noticing now that like my pace of wanting to level up a bunch of people is slowing a little bit, just because like I can't even have room on my roster for all these people. Like I leveled up Zhao, and he essentially made me bench Ka-Ching because they filled the same role, and Ka-Ching used to be my main. But like getting him and leveling him up, it kind of made her a little obsolete outside of, you know, specific things that are going to need an Electro person. But it's just, yeah, I don't know how motivated I'm going to be to keep building a massive roster, just because of you can only use four at a time. And once you have, you know, a great champ of each element, it's the drive goes down a little bit, but you know, it's gotcha. You want to pull the things, and that's how it goes. But I'm still having fun with it. Destiny is picked back up again, so I've been mostly playing that and just checking in to spend my resin and do these daily things every so often with Genshin. But Genshin really got me through the kind of dry spell of Destiny over the last month or so, and it's obviously something I'm sticking with long term. It came out in September, and it is now February, and here I am. So yeah, it's great. I'm sure you didn't watch this video if you're not playing Genshin, but if you haven't, give it a shot. And I guess that was the extent of Evie's cameo. She's sleeping over there. But I will see you guys next time. And probably it's back to Destiny after this. So take care. I'll see you soon.